So, pilot for the today's flight is Manvi, that is me, and I will take you to Malaysia. Okay, so do you remember the task which I gave you? Abir, Arika.
Yes, ma'am, I remember.
Okay, so can you tell me the image you can see? Can you tell me what are these stars? Can you name them?
I don't know.
So, did you search about the destinations in the Malaysia?
Yes, ma'am, I have one.
Okay, that's okay. So we'll talk to them one by one. Okay. So next, Sonu. So first, we will talk about the location of the Malaysia. So Malaysia is a Southeast Asian country which occupies the parts of Malay Peninsula and in the island of the Borneo. So capital of the Malaysia is Kuala Lumpur, and this is the national capital and the largest city of Malaysia. And talking about the currency, so here you can see the image as well. The currency of Malaysia is Malaysian ringgit, or it is also known as the Malaysian dollar. So here you can see the currency as well. Okay, now coming up to the national flag. So the national flag of Malaysia consists of seven red and seven white horizontal stripes and a blue canton with a yellow star and a crescent, which you can see in the image as well. So this flag is originated from the flag of Federation of Malaya. The flag of Malaysia is named after the Jalur Gemilang, which means that stripes of excellence or the stripes of glory in Malay. So the width to length ratio of this flag is 1 to 2.
If I put a Malaysian and a US flag, they look very similar.
Yes, actually. Like there are most of the flags which are similar to each other.
It's just like the flag of Niger and India.
Yes, like you can like there are so many flags which are resemble to each other.
Yeah.
Okay, next. Okay, so now talking about the culture. So Malaysia is a multicultural society. The main ethnic groups are Native Malaysia, as well as the large population of the Chinese and Indian. So if you visit this particular country, moreover, you will find people belonging from the India or from the China. And here you can spot from the images as well. So they are wearing the Malaysian attire. So they have the mixed culture actually. Okay, now talking about the different religions at this place. So as I have told you that this place is majorly having people from the India and the China, so that is why there are so many religions in this place. So talking specifically about the Kuala Lumpur's religion, so this place is basically dominant with the Islamic religion. So you can see over here, like 60% of the religion is occupied with the Islamic. And then there is also a large Chinese population which follows a mix of religions from the traditional Chinese religion like the Buddhism and the Taoism. Here you can see the percentages as well. So the Buddhism here is 35.7%. So the 35.7% of the population is the Buddhism. Also, there are some Hinduism which are practiced by the Malaysian Indians. So it is all about 8.5%. And talking about the other, it is the Christianity. So there are over 5.8% of the population in the Kuala Lumpur who belongs to the Christian religion. And other than that, there are some also the minor religions, which includes the Baha and the Sikhism. So these are a few religions which you can find, and that is how you can say that this country is multicultural, as you can find people from various religions. Now coming up to the next, talking about the population and the language spoken. So first talking about the language. So here you can see from the picture that there are 0.9.2 million the ratio of the men and 0.87 million of the women in this place. So as I have told you about the religion, so you can also spot about the languages spoken. So there are four different main languages which are majorly spoken at this place. That is Bahasa Malaysia, Malaysian English, Chinese languages, and the Indian languages. So you all know that Malaysia is a tourist country, right? It is really famous for its tourism. So English is widely spoken in this country. So yes, that is why you can see over here like Malaysian English as well as the Indian English. And other than that, the Bahasa Melayu is a national and the official language of Malaysia. It is Bahasa Melayu. Okay, so now coming up to the fascinating factor, that is the geographical aspects of this country. So there are two major parts of this country. The one is Peninsular Malaysia to the west, and the other is East Malaysia to the east. So the total land area of this country, Malaysia, is around 3,29,847 square kilometers. And this is the 66th largest country in the world in the terms of area. So can you tell me the world's largest country?
Of course, Russia.
Okay, and the second largest country?
Canada.
Canada.
Yes. So talking about
and,
the
land... sixth is India, I guess.
All right. So Malaysia holds the 66th position in talking about the terms of the land area. Okay, so now coming on to the next. So the next term is climate. So as this country is located near to the equator, so the climate is categorized as the equatorial. Like it is being somehow, it is being like hot and humid throughout the year. Coming up to the next is the mountains. So the highest mountain range in Malaysia is the Crocker Range in Sabah, which divides the state in half. So this range includes of the following, that is Mount Kinabalu, Mount Tambuyukon, Trusmadi Range, and Bombalai Hill. So these are the few mountain ranges you can visit and see. Now, talking about the island in Malaysia. So island, so this country has so many of the islands and some of the largest islands as well. So the one of the largest island of Malaysia is Bangi Island. So this island is actually followed by the Batu Island, the Langkawi Island, and the Penang Island. So the largest island shared with another country is Borneo. And here you can see the map of the Malaysia. So it Malaysia basically lies within the world coral reef.
Akka, ma'am.
Yes, Abhi.
I know one very tiny island that's in Malaysia.
All right.
It's called Sipadan Island. It's so small that you can walk around the whole thing in just 1 hour.
All right. So did you search about it or you already knew about this?
I already knew about this.
All right. That's really good to know. Okay, coming up to the next slide. Talking about the national animal and the bird. So here you can see the national animal is Malayan tiger. And the national bird is Rhino hornbills.
The Malayan tiger looks so beautiful to me.
Yes. Yes, Arika.
Yes, ma'am. I wanted to say it just looks like our Indian tiger and our Indian national animal is also a tiger.
Yes. All right. Okay, so now I'll take you to the must visiting place in Malaysia. So before we explore, so I would like to know from you, like, have you searched about the tourist places of this country? Anyone? Yes, Arika.
I know one, Georgetown.
Yes.
Yes, I've searched only one.
Okay. Okay, so anyone else? Arhan, did you search about it?
No, ma'am.
All right, that's okay. So I'll take you to the beautiful places in Malaysia. So the first one here we'll see, the Petronas Tower. So did you remember the same tower you watched in the welcome slide of the Malaysia? Did you remember? So this is actually the twin tower, which is basically named as the Petronas Tower. So it is in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. So the height of this tower is 1,483 feet. So this tower has 88 floors. So the Petronas Tower remains the tallest twin towers in the world, which was invented by an architect. His name is Fazlur Rahman Khan. So these twin towers feature a double-decker sky bridge, which connects the two towers on the 41st and 42nd floors. So here you can see the connecting between these two towers in the middle, right? So these towers connect to each other on the floor number 41 and 42. And this is also the highest two-story bridge in the world. So this building has 88 floors.
So but ma'am, Burj Khalifa has more than.
Yes, Burj Khalifa is world's tallest building.
This is Malaysia's.
Yeah, so this is actually the twin tower. Burj Khalifa is a single building, but this is a twin tower.
Oh, yeah. And ma'am, what is that, the national bird? Rhino bill?
Hornbill.
Hornbill.
Yes. Okay, so coming up to the next destination, it is Selangor. So Selangor actually describes the Malaysia's most developed and the populated state that leads up to the Kuala Lumpur's urban sprawl. So here you can see the image of the famous cave. This is the Batu Cave.
I know, I've seen this online and the statue.
All right, okay, that's great. So here you can see the first image where you can see a few stairs. Like there are so many stairs. If you go up to the stairs, you will see the second view, the second image. Like you have to walk on so many stairs and then you will get, at the end you will get to look about this view.
Oh.
Okay, so this is actually the famous Batu Caves. So there are a Hindu shrine with the largest statue of the Lord Murugan. So the Lord Murugan was the god of the war. So the Batu Cave draw a large crowd, especially during the Thapusam holiday. So this is also one of the most famous tourist spot in Malaysia. So coming up with the third one. So this is Putra Mosque. So the Putra Mosque is the principal mosque which is in Malaysia. So it was constructed back in 1997 and it took almost 2 years to complete the construction of this place. So this is actually the pink-domed Putra Mosque, which is constructed with raw sintered granite, and it consists of three main functional areas. So those are the prayer hall, then the sahan, and the courtyard. And there are also other various learning facilities and the function rooms.
Because they were building it near a river, that's why it's 2 years old. That's why it took 2 years.
Yes, actually. So this mosque can accommodate around 15,000 worshippers at a single time. So did you like this mosque? The beauty of this place?
Yes.
Yeah.
It looks more, it looks more like a harbor than a mosque.
Okay.
Because it's right next to the river.
Yeah, actually.
And this looks like Jade Palace also.
Okay. All right. So coming up to the next. So the next star is
Antar.
Yes. So do you remember the name of the stars which I shown you earlier?
Yes, ma'am. The what was that? Petronas Towers.
Petronas Towers. So that was the twin star. And the KL tower, it is the communication tower actually. So it features an antenna that increases its heights up to the 421 meters. So do you remember the height of the twin tower which I showed you earlier?
Yes, ma'am, 88.
Yeah. Okay. So it is the seventh tallest freestanding tower in the world. So if you visit at the top of the tower, you will get this aerial view of this city, Kuala Lumpur. So here an image of aerial view is also shown.
Voila.
Okay, so coming up to the next, it is Avana Skyway. So Genting Skyway is a gondola lift connecting with Gotong Jaya and the resort hotel in Genting Highland. So this skyway can carry more than 2,000 people per hour with 8 passengers per gondola. So you can travel through this within and it can carry 2,000 people within an hour. So the maximum speed of this is 6 meters per second. Yes. And the total to travel to this place, it will totally take up to 15 minutes. And it also may depend upon the weather conditions as well. So if weather is not so good, so the speed will be a little low. Otherwise, it will go on its normal speed. And it will take you 15 minutes to travel to this place. And you can enjoy the view as well.
Nice.
Yes, actually. Okay, so now coming up to the next. So this is the Harrison. So it is the Malaysian brand of the chocolates, which was found in the 2005. Have you heard about this chocolate brand before? This is Harrison, the chocolate brand which was made in Malaysia in 2005. Okay, so would you try this chocolate?
Yes, ma'am.
You must give a try to this chocolate.
Okay. Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, my Masi bought this chocolate for me from Malaysia. She lives in Malaysia.
All right. So you have tried this chocolate, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So how does it taste like?
It tastes good.
Okay. All right. So now coming up to the food of Malaysia. So, do you know what kind of food the people of Malaysia eat?
No.
Any idea?
No.
Like, most common guess you can give is the chicken or meat. Like, yeah. Every Western country, they have, like, chicken in their food, right?
Yes,
so there are a few... Arika, do you want to say something?
Yes, ma'am. I just wanted to say... Over this left-hand side, I think,
Yeah. So I'll tell you about some of the food in Malaysia. So there is a famous national food that is named as Mee Goreng Mamak. It is actually, I don't know how to be pronounced in Malaysian language. So this is actually the Indian Muslim dish. So it is a complete package of the Indian as well as the Muslim dish. So this dish basically has a beef or chicken. And it is like filled with soy sauce and some of the veggies and the eggs. And there is also a bit of chili which is tossed in it for the flavor. And there is one more national dish which is named as Appam Balik. So this is a pancake style snack. Have you tried pancake before?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so in Malaysia, there is a similar dish that is named as the Appam Balik. So this dish usually has the package of an omelet and it is stuffed with more than a sufficient amount of sugar. And also there are some peanuts and the corns. So these are the main two national dishes of Malaysia. The one is Appam Balik. And the second one is Mee Goreng Mamak. Okay, so now coming up to the next. So these are the pictures of the Kuala Lumpur Airport. Here you can see like how beautiful the the infrastructure of airports look like.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, so now coming up to the next. So here you can see some of the Malaysian airlines.
Wait, I want to tell you something.
Yes.
I think I passed the top of this airport when I was going to Singapore once. I think I passed this airport on the top.
All right. So you remember the view?
No, it was dark. I was in a plane.
All right. Okay. Okay. So talking about the Malaysian Airlines, so there are a few major airlines of this country. The one is AirAsia. Have you heard about this airlines before? AirAsia.
Yes, I have.
Yeah.
I have.
Yeah. And then
AirAsia and Malaysia Airlines. These two.
Okay. Okay. Then there are a few more other airlines as well. So there are Bajaj, Firefly, and Malindo Air.
Oh, it looks interesting.
Yes, actually.
Ma'am, can you just go to the previous slide?
Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Actually, when I saw it first known in this slide only, I thought that this is also a blessed place to visit. It
looks okay. Actually, like this, this place has some of the 5-star airports. Like even if you visit France as well, so the airports are at France are like there are 5-star airports.
Oh, so, good thing to know.
Yeah, actually. So these, like the infrastructure is really good. So you can like consider it as a destination place. You can visit this place.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Okay, so that was all about our today's tour to the Malaysia. I hope you all have learned and enjoyed a lot.
Okay. Yes. Okay. Tomorrow, where we are visiting?
Tomorrow, we are visiting Mauritius.
Mauritius?
Yes.
I think it's very tiny on the map.
Yeah, it is very tiny.
Okay, so I have a task for you all. You all have to search about some facts about this country.
Ma'am, can you just tell the spelling of this country?
Yes, it is
R-I. Okay.
Yes.
R-I,
then
T-I-U-S. Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah, so we'll visit Mauritius tomorrow and you all have to search about the facts of this country.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so bye, everyone. Have a good day.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am. Thank you.
Bye, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Ma'am. Bye. Thank you, ma'am.